London Zoo, one of the UK's top tourist attractions. But it could have been a victim of the COVID-19 pandemic, as it closed its doors for a record 3 months. The animals here cost a staggering 1 million euros a month to feed, and lockdown meant euthanasia for some was a possibility.
We were starting to have to think of the worst case scenario. Had lockdown continued for another 6 months and our finances quite literally dried up, we would then have to look at, well, how would we feed all of these animals? Fortunately, we didn't get close to that, but had lockdown continued for a significant period, then I think all zoos would have been having to ask some very, very difficult questions.
The new restrictions mean no interacting with the animals, so no more feeding or handling experiences. Instead, there are one-way routes and signage reminding people to keep their distance.
I think it's totally understandable that parts of the zoo are going to remain closed. But still, for my son, who's 2 and a half, who loves seeing the gorillas and the tiger and, you know, all the animals outside, he got to have an amazing experience and he was super happy.
Well, let's hope the classic attractions like these penguins at London Zoo will attract the crowds. But what about the smaller zoos that rely on interactive experiences? How will they cope with the new zoo normal? Cedars Nature Centre in Hertfordshire is one of the UK's smallest zoos, home to Britain's only Zorilla, a striped polecat. It used to offer interactive experiences, but no longer.
Actually, physically touching the animals will be something that the public will not be able to do. They'll be able to get nice and close to within 2 metres to get their lovely photographs, but everything will be changing for us and for every other zoo in the UK.
The zoo considered shutting down, but an appeal to the local community helped save it. The UK zoos will be hoping for a busy summer and no further lockdowns, so their businesses and their animals stay safe. Victoria Smith, Euronews, London.